Hello everybody, it is MonkeyPuzzle and I am back with you here in the snowstorm on the tropical center. Pretty ridiculous, but we won't talk about that. But yeah, it's time for episode number 3. I know, man, I know, right? Anyway, I've done a few things without you, but I have tried not to do too much, so let's get going with some stuff now that you are here. Where have you been? Come on. So anyway, one of the things is these crops, and also I noticed in the other videos, these shadows are pretty severe from these cliffs and stuff, so sorry if the lighting changes a lot in the videos, but that's just the thing. Whoa, look at those crops. That's been an ongoing bug with crops, and we'll just pretend that they're having growth spurts. Wah! Put a little fertilizer on. Wah! All right, still up there. Anyway, yeah, I have started crops because I want to make kibble. I also threw in some narco berries in here too, because why not? I have a whole plethora of spoiled meat, and the trike can get it, but it's a little bit of work to do it, and this is so easy. So I'll just collect all this up. This one, oh, it needs some more fertilizer, right. So speaking of fertilizer, let's go check on that. You would think I would put the compost bins right next to the crops, but used to be a bunch of scary stuff spawned down here. I haven't seen anything spawn down here for a while. I put in a note to Neocryptor, the admin, like, what's going on? But I am seeing scary stuff on other parts of the map, so all is not lost. With that, let's go ahead and get some spoiled meat and just get this crafting up while I got it in my inventory. So let's just throw all these goodies in here, and not the poop, and then we can make 158. Excellent. Always need more narcotics. Never thought I would say that on camera. Anyway, up here I tamed a pooper. He was only level 30. He or she, actually, yeah, it's a he. Fecundity, which means fertility, if you don't know. And got fecundity with some food and some thatch and a bunch of these guys on him. We're going to need about 15. No, we got 5 already, so we need 10 more poops. Count the poops. 3 poops, 4 poops, ha 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 ha, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9. That should be 10 poops. Get a little extra, and you get some health, and it gets to be happy and jump around a bit. So it's pretty dark. Let me turn this up again. Let's try 0.9. Yeah, okay. Oop. And get these. So, not the most exciting thing, but I put it up here because I thought that fecundity would be just too tempting a bait if we get anything scary coming through here. We have had spinos and aloes and all kinds of stuff. So yeah, I'm just making fertilizer up here right next to fecundity, and you can do that many at a time. So 2 at a time. I didn't do beetles, even though they're way more efficient. You get lots more fertilizer. You don't have to use thatch. Oh, I guess I have to redo them all. I need some more poop. Anyway, I'll do the rest of this without you. But I barely even know where any caves are here on the center, let alone feeling prepared to go ahead in there. You know, I need to get some mounts. I need to get a saber or something like that. So I will do that in the meantime. Right now, we're just doing this the old-fashioned way. So while I'm doing this, I could talk a little bit, I guess. I need to do that anyway. So I want to gear up. I want to do a couple things. One of the things is I want to gear up for this big building project we're going to do. So I got to start making a bunch of parts and getting ready for that. And some of that requires new stuff. Some of it requires old stuff. For the lumber parts, I need a bunch of stone. I could keep doing it with my axe, but I should rather get a tame to do that. So I want to get a dodicarus or dodicurus or however you pronounce it. I just call them dodies. I want to tame a dodie. I want to tame an Enki, and that is one of the big purposes of the crops, is I want to get some kibble to do that with, so I can just be more efficient and not be using my axe up. And we also need to get into some of the new materials that are available in here. So I don't want to spend the whole day taming with you all, although it's going to take, you know, a good portion of the day for me to do that. And the update's supposed to come out soon, so I'll be jumping over to the island today as well to check out some of the new dinos and all that. I'm not sure if they'll be here right away. History says no, probably not. So yeah, we need some of the utility tames. Also a beaver should be in that mix, just to help us get building materials more quickly so we can do something really awesome down there. I've been talking with some of the guys about what we want to build, and it sounds pretty cool. So hopefully we'll have a meeting soon and become of one mind with that. Oh, I got a level. Very cool. What am I giving it to? I need fortitude for sure. Also, I've died a couple times, and when I'm running around naked trying to get my gear, I found stamina was my limiter. So we're going to bring that up. So I got some crystal with the pteranodon I got last time. This is the last thing we did in the last episode, is I tamed this. And I went from there and I went getting some crystal and some metal. So I'm fairly stocked up on metal. I got some crystal and I made some spy glasses so I can spy on things. See the levels of dinos before they're actually attacking me, which is pretty cool. So I went around giving them to folks. I gave one to Jimbob Sauce. He's a new guy on the server. You should check him out. He's down in the description. I've been watching him for a while. Very cool dude. And he returned the favor with some iron armor, which is awesome. It's called iron armor here, not flak. Cryo left me a bunch of bees. He left me a note, Jimbob did, saying thanks for the spyglass. And he also left me some dodo kibble. Ooh, poor Alpenuckers. Crackpot McCraw got killed. I have to see if he needs some help in a second, but he left us some dodo egg kibble, so that's good for pteranodons and mesopithecuses, and there was a bit more, but I think it might have spoiled in the chest over there. But anyway, we've got some of that, but what I really need is some dillo egg kibble to get these rock breakers, the Enki and the Dodecurus. And speaking of all this stuff and new materials, we need to move up from the preserving bin and the preserving shed for meat is okay, but I found out it does not make kibble, or not kibble, but jerky. And we're gonna need jerky in order to make some of this kibble. So the next level up is the smokehouse, and I couldn't figure out how to do it last time because I needed brick and I had forgotten how to do that, but I have since done my homework and I needed clay. So there's an engram for it. And then if you go in here, I guess we have to go back in again. And now there it is, clay. And clay is claystone plus limestone. You get limestone when you pick at metal nodes. And so I managed to do some of that with my pteranodon because they're all up high, up on the little plateaus and stuff. So now we can go ahead and turn that into clay. And then if we take a certain amount of that clay, I'm not sure how much, and we go ahead and put it in the refining forge, if I remember all this correctly, then I need some firewood to get this all going. I'm using firewood because it's probably one of the more efficient fuel sources here. Now we can go ahead and light the fire, and in some amount of time, that's going to turn into bricks. Not sure how much time. You can see some of this metal I've been stocking up on. Can I reach? Oh, yeah, I can. I'll throw some of that in there. See if we have bricks yet. Not yet. I'd say I'm going to skip ahead, but as soon as I do that, it'll probably go ahead and make... a little time forward. I'm still sitting here. Waiting for it. I have the feeling I'm missing something. So I'll be right back. I'm going to go look that up. Oh, there it is. No, I got it right. There is brick. All right, I let it go even a little bit further, and it seems like you get 15 bricks for every one clay. It does take a while, but you can just leave it in here and let it get going. So let's go ahead and put those bricks now over here in the construction table, which is like the smithy for Primitive Plus. And then this is one of the fridges, even though it's not really a fridge. And now we can go ahead and make the smokehouse. So I think that's what it's going to take in order for us to make jerky. And while I'm doing this, I might as well put on my new iron armor. That's pretty cool. And then I can, I'll put the leather up on my rescue bird to where when that happens, I've got an extra pteranodon. Here, I'll show you real quick, and then we'll put the smokehouse down. I died enough times, and I found one of the problems with having a pteranodon is if you die somewhere, you don't have anywhere to get back out there. So I got a super low level one when I was in a moment of dire emergency. And so we'll just go ahead and put this on it. And thank you again, Jimbob Sauce, for the gifts. And thank you again, Cryo, for the drone bees. We got to get the apiary started too. So many things to do that I don't want to do without you. So I think with the smokehouse, this preserving campfire is going to be obsolete. So let's see if we can take all of that. I can't move, but I don't think I need to for a second. So let's go ahead and demolish that act of faith and go ahead and put this down. Oh yeah, remember, it's got this cool little shape to it. Yeah, it's got a little lean-to thing going on. So there's the smokehouse. And now let's go ahead and put all this stuff back. We got old meat and spoiled meat and spark powder and eggs, and don't need wood in there, don't think. So now I think if we, can I move again? Yes. If we take the cooked meat and the organic oil, we should be able to put it in here, and it should make should go ahead and make jerky. We'll check back before the end of the episode to make sure that that is truly the case. If it takes actual oil, I can go ahead and get that down in the lake. There's some of it. And then let me just get this fertilizer off me, put it back in my crops, and then we'll go fly off and do a couple other things. We're going to look for those utility tames. And I'm also going to, I need an obsidian pick, and I wanted to do that with you all. So we will go off to Batman Island, get some obsidian, and make an obsidian pick. So I'll see you with all that in just a second. All right, I gave it a minute or more, it's just an expression, and it made three jerkies so far. So it confirmed it does work with the organic oil, so that's cool. You can make jerky with seeds, but it's slow as usual. So I only have three of them so far. So I can go ahead and put them in here. And hopefully that's all I need for Dillo egg kibble. Oh, well, there's actually one very important part I forgot, which is the Dillo eggs. I only have seven of, for some reason. I have this many dodo eggs. They're being very stingy about laying their eggs, and I'm not sure why. But anyway, Jimbob Sauce has been nice enough that he said I could go exchange my dodo egg kibble for some dillo egg kibble. So I'm going to do that, and then we're going to go off, and I'll meet you when I get somewhere. I just want to see this make one kibble before we go. Let me check out. See, dillo eggs, citronelle, cooked meat, jerky, major berry, and fiber. So yeah, it's all in there. There it is. So it works. I just want to confirm that that does work on Primitive Plus. So I will meet you when I get somewhere. Over at Jim Bob's place, he's over on the island with the blue obelisk and looks like he's busy collecting rocks with his Anki. There he is, and he's got a little place over here. Quite a dangerous neighborhood he's in. He's been, he's lost everything quite a few times. I helped him kill a Therizinosaurus once, indeed. Well, what's he got in here? He's got a whole bunch of dillo egg kibble, and that's what we need. So I'm going to give him back the dodo stuff, and we're going to take 9 of that. So thank you very much, man. And let's just take a aerial look at his place real quick. He's got a greenhouse going on and a bunch of stuff. He's got some neat vids out. He was doing some creature trapping with yurts. So you should check him out. He's, like I said, he's in the description below. Heyo. All right, I'm over here on what they call Batman Island, Batman with teeth. And it's one of the few places they're obsidian. There's probably more, I bet you, over on that volcano over there. And Jimbob is recommending I use a yurt to trap my tame. So we might have to make a diversion and actually start some bees to get some beeswax to make a yurt. I think that's part of what's involved. So anyway, plenty of obsidian, but also some bad guys here. Let me get the attention of everybody on the ground here if I can. And we'll just take them all off the edge. And I'll have to deal with that bat as well. So let me finish dealing with these guys. And then let's talk about the obsidian pick. Okay, there goes the Onyx. Let me get some food from a hungry fighter here. I think there was one more thing up here. Yeah, or two more things. Let's get them off the edge, too. Hello. I'm a tasty morsel. Yes, I am. Come get me. There you go. And you too. Probably should have killed them to get some prime, but I'm too far away from my base to cook them. All right, I think we're in the clear now. Let's land in the sun. Let's go ahead and get our pickaxe out and get some obsidian. We all notice you also get some carbon with that. I think that's an ingredient that you can cook with iron in order to make steel. Now, let's see. I don't think I've learned it yet. Let's go ahead and get the obsidian pickaxe. There it is. That thing. No. Oh, and I got to make it out of smithy. All right, we'll have to go back. I'll meet you back. And maybe I should get a little bit more just to make sure I have enough. Alrighty, back at the base. Let's throw that stuff in here. And then, will it be in melee? There it is. Obsidian pickaxe. 20 obsidian, 5 wood, 10 hide. Let's go ahead and make it. And we'll talk about what that's for in just a second. Let's grab it. And then also, let's go ahead and check out what it takes to make the apiary. I've already learned it. And I guess I can just make it, oh, in the construction table. So let's see if we can make one of those as well. Because I'm pretty sure that I need it to make the yurt, which I should also learn, and I have already learned. Okay, so in craftables, yurt takes, yurt takes, yeah, leather, fiber, and beeswax. So beeswax is what we need to get to. So let's go ahead in here and I wonder what it would be in. Not crafting, maybe wood. Yeah, there it is, the apiary. And we need the wood planks, which are down here in the lumber station. Whee! All right, so we just grab a stack of those. And let me brighten things up here for you a bit. Just a bit, otherwise the torches get way too yellow and my little HUDs get really bright. So, all right, that's in there. So then in wood, we can make an apiary. I'll probably make more than one after the ep just to get things really happening. But let's go ahead throw one down with, I've been saving up some bees. So let's just grab about five of those right now. Got plenty of drones. Did I grab them? I did. And put them down here somewhere. Ooh, look, you can see bees around them already. Okay. So in there, we're going to throw some queen bees and some drones. And those should combine to form some worker bees, which is pretty cool. I don't know how long it takes. I guess I shouldn't stand here and watch it. But then it'll start making honey and beeswax. So we'll peek in there before the end, but manage to get that going. Now let's go compare these pickaxes. So here we got my regular metal pickaxe, or iron pickaxe in this case. Actually, let me do something. My little recording thing was in the way, so I couldn't see how much I was gathering. So let's try that again. Here, you can see I'm getting flint, iron, and a little bit of claystone, and some stone. Now, if I switch to the obsidian one, which I should probably do the same kind of rock. Actually, that one you can't harvest. Let's do this one. Suddenly, I'm getting a whole ton of claystone. So what this thing does is it gives the alternative products that you get from picking things from Primitive Plus even more so. So from regular rocks, I'll get a ton of claystone. From obsidian, I'll get a ton of carbon. And from metal, I'll get a ton of limestone. So that's going to help me make more of the Primitive Plus stuff. So now we've got that. These guys haven't done their thing. So I guess I'm going to have to wait. So I think this has probably gone on long enough today. I didn't know I haven't really done what I set out to do yet. But we've done a lot of good prep. We've got kibble going on and jerky and crops. And we're going to make some beeswax. And we're going to make a yurt in the beginning of the next episode to do this all with. I got the obsidian pickaxe for gathering the Primitive Plus materials. So first thing next episode, we'll make a yurt. And we'll see if it works as well as Jimbob Sauce says it does for trapping these things. In the meantime, I will do the work of locating a Doty and an Enki and a Beaver. These are all the things I want from my utility crew so we can start building. So I'll see you in the next one. Thank you for watching until the very end of this episode. Bye-bye.